Here we go, we are going to find the power series expansion centered at 0 for this function, namely 1 over parentheses with 1 minus x inside and then to the second power. I know. So here we go, let's just put it down right here. First of all, let's write down what we know. Of course, our best friend, 1 over 1 minus x. This right here is the sum as n goes from 0 to infinity, x to the nth power. And don't forget, we should also give the radius and also the interval of convergence. So I will tell you, based on this, we know absolute value of x is less than 1. And with that being said, we know r is 1. And from here, we can also say the I. For the best friend, we go from negative 1 to 1. And we do not include both endpoints. So this right here is what we know. Now, check this out. How can we go from 1 over 1 minus x to 1 over 1 minus x squared? Well, you might be thinking, can we just square both sides? Technically, yes, but it's going to be harder to do because when you square a power series right here, remember you have to put the parentheses here and then square. And remember, this right here, it's an infinite polynomial. When you square that, it's not easy to do. It's doable, but it's not easy, all right? But anyway, let's think about how we can do another operation so we can go from our best friend to this new friend. Don't forget about calculus. Of course, we're in the calculus class, right? If we integrate our best friend, we'll end up with some kind of natural log. But how about if we differentiate our best friend, what we will get, right? Well, if we differentiate this guy based on the quotient rule, if you would like, you will see that you will have to square the denominator, and that's the good thing. So this is what we'll do. We'll just look at this and differentiate both sides and see what happens. So here we go. Based on this, we are going to differentiate both sides. Now, perhaps I'll write this down right here for you guys. Real quick, somewhere on the side, let me just put down some note right here for you guys. Perhaps the easier way to differentiate this is this. I will put this down. When you differentiate that, I can look at this as 1 minus x raised to the negative 1 power, like this. And when we do that, we can bring the power to the front and the minus 1. So we get negative, and then this right here stays the same. So we have 1 minus x raised to the negative 2 power. But don't forget the chain rule. We have to multiply by the derivative of the inside. The derivative of 1 minus x is negative 1. So be sure we multiply by negative 1. This times that, it's positive. This right here can go down to the denominator. So all in all, we get 1 over 1 minus x, parentheses, square. Very, very nice. Therefore, on the left-hand side, we get nicely equal to 1 over 1 minus x to the second power. Very nice. And as of the right-hand side, of course, we can just do our usual derivative with the power right here, because this is technically like a power function. We can just bring the n to the front, and then minus 1. That's pretty much it. So we can say this right here is equal to the sum as n goes from something to infinity. You'll see why I say something, right? Well, you can put the n right here first, n and then x to the n minus 1 power, like this, right? So now, here's the deal. Earlier, it was 0. If I maintain the 0, it's okay, it's not wrong, but check this out. If I put n is equal to 0, well, the first term is you plug in 0 into this n and that n, you end up with 0 times x to the 0 minus 1 power, like that. 0 times this is just 0, so it's nothing. Usually, when this kind of things happen, we will just like to say n is equal to 1. You lose the first term because the first term was a constant. So when you have n equals 1, you know, you can start with the actual term, the non-zero term. But anyway, this right here is the form of the power series for this guy, 1 over 1 minus x to the second power. It's like our best friend and you power that up, right? Let's see. What else can we do right here? I think we also need to get the r and also the I, so let's check that out. Well, when we differentiate, the good thing is that the radius of convergence will stay the same, but we should double check the interval of convergence. So I is going to be from negative 1 to 1. But let's just do this real quick. Well, check the convergence at the endpoints. So I will check when x is equal to negative 1. We put this right here. And we will get the sum as n goes from 1 to infinity. And again, this is just checking for the convergence at the endpoints. Put negative 1 into this x, we get n times negative 1 raised to the n minus 1 power. This right here is alternating, but this is n times that. Unfortunately, this doesn't even go to 0 in the first place. If you look at this, if you take the limit as n goes to infinity of n times negative 1 to the n minus 1, this right here technically is a DNE, doesn't exist situation, and doesn't exist, of course, does not mean 0. Therefore, this right here diverges by TFD. So this right here, we still do not include the endpoints. Right, endpoints right there. And now, we'll have to check x equal to 1. Put 1 into the x right here. So we get the sum as n goes from 1 to infinity, n times 1 to the n minus 1 power. This is just always 1. In another word, this is the sum as n goes from 1 to infinity of n, namely all the natural numbers, namely 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and so on. Let's just add them up. The answer to that is not negative 1 over 12. If you know the reference, leave a comment down below. But anyway, this right here, I'll just tell you, if you take the limit of this as n goes to infinity, you technically will end up with infinity. And of course, infinity is not equal to 0. This right here, technically, it's not infinity because here you have negative 1, positive 1. So it's kind of bumps up and down. So the answer to this limit is doesn't exist. But the answer to this limit is infinity. But anyway, this is also not 0, so we get a divergent when x is equal to 1, and this diverges by test for divergence. Come here and give that a parenthesis. And with all that, we are done. I will just box everything right here for the answer. Like this.